this take more attention than this, guys. Ciao guys, and welcome back. I'm Luca, and in today's video I want to talk about my minimalist run and gun setup. It is pretty simple. I just have a 24mm T1.5, the Panasonic Lumix S1, the Rod Video Micro Pro NTG. This is the Rod Video Mic NTG that is really versatile because I can also use it with a USB port or just with the smartphone, so I can record voiceover or memories on the go. I'm using this microphone because it can split the audio in two mono channels, the one at the proper volume and one with some decibel lower, so you'll be sure that your audio is not gonna clip if you don't play too much with this wheel. Camera strap. That is from Peak Design. I use mostly this because it's modular, so I can both use it if I'm walking or if I'm doing some pan and tilt on the go, and I don't want to bring the gimbal with me, also because that gimbal, I have the Ronin S that weighs 1 kilo or more, I don't remember, so I never used that gimbal once I bought this camera because the IBIS of this camera is pretty outstanding. And so with this camera strap I can also attach it here, that's why I have another anchor, so I can also use it as simple camera holder. And the last tool is the Peak Design Clip V3. I don't remember. Is the one that you can both clip it on your shoulder, so you can just grab your camera as fast as possible when something is happening, and I don't have to stress my wrist for the whole day holding the camera. And you can both attach it to your shoulder or to the Manfrotto tripod. I have this version because I also have that type of Manfrotto tripods for photography reasons, so I don't have to unscrew and screw out this thing. Talking about the filter, I'm using the Polar Pro Quartz Line ND64 polarized. I'm using this intensity of filter because I like to film at T2 or F1.8, and having a dual ISO camera gives me a lot of versatility because I can just use base ISO and the second gain of the circuit to increase the brightness of the image. So if I'm filming something under bright light, I just go down to ISO 640, and if I'm filming under the shades, I can crank up the ISO to ISO 4000. So I'm gonna enable the second gain of the camera and I'm gonna have clean images even if I'm using the ND64. So it's pretty modular and convenient to have a dual ISO sensor camera. And that's why I don't use variable ND filters, because I can just use two filters in one thanks to the sensor of the camera. And the last piece of gear that I use 99% of the time for documentary filmmaking is the 24mm T1.5 or F1.4. With the ability of punching to a Super 35 crop sensor, does it make sense? So the ability to zoom in with the sensor that I'm gonna crop to Super 35, I'm gonna have an equivalent of 35mm T1.4, and that's a pretty sweet focal length if I wanna have a close-up of my subjects without having too much distortion. And I forgot to mention this eye cap, that it's pretty convenient during a bright daylight. And this is a pretty sweet piece of tool because I will not have filtration of light inside my eyes when I look through the viewfinder. So I'm gonna be sure that the image is gonna look good and I'm grabbing focus properly. It's not that easy when you shoot at T1.5 or T2, mostly with a wide angle lens. I have less problems with the 50mm. With that lens I feel it's a little bit easier to pull focus, but with wide angle lenses I find it a little bit tricky. Mostly because I cannot punch in the viewfinder while I'm filming. It's a limitation of the Lumix S cameras that you cannot check if the subject is in focus while you're already filming. That's why sometimes when I can bring with me, I put a monitor on top of the camera that is 100% of the time just zoom in, just in case I'm not sure if the subject is not in focus, so I can just jump from eye cup to the monitor to check if the subject is 100% in focus. So this is my Minimalist run and gun kit. I also use it rigged up, but I mean, I can work 99% of the time just with this without any problems. I hope that this video was interesting. If you have any question, feel free to ask in the comment area below. And if you like it, put a thumb up, I will really appreciate. And if you would like to subscribe, it would be really nice as well. Thank you for watching, guys, and I hope I'll see you next time. Ciao! I forgot to talk about the headphones. Sometimes we should monitor the audio while filming. You never know what's happening in the background. For example, now I'm filming and my neighbor is doing the garden. There is a really wild little bird doing something naughty. And some cars there, dogs. I hope you're not picking up the sound. I don't know why, guys, everybody is thinking that this thing is cute, but I hate it. I cannot really look at this. Oh, so relaxing. I miss my cats. They are in Italy.